Hi guys, and welcome to a brand new series that I'm doing on the game Ark Survival Evolved. Playing the game single player. It's a survival game with dinosaurs in, basically. Should be able to see some if we look around. It's early release on Steam at the moment. I think it's out on Xbox as well. But it's been around for a long time. And I think an expansion's just come out for it. You can see some dinosaurs down there. We'll check those out in a bit. But yeah, at heart, it's a survival game. So we're going to start it from scratch. As you can see, I've got nothing in my inventory. And we've got no skills or anything like that unlocked. I've played around with the game a little bit, but I'm by no means an expert at it in any way. So, as with every survival game since Minecraft, we start by punching a tree, or a dead tree in this instance. And we need to get some resources up to make the first tool that we already have the blueprint for in craftables, which will be this stone pick. So we're going to need some more thatch and one stone. So we can get thatch from doing what we're doing there, which is punching this stuff. And we can get stones from picking them up off the ground to start with. And then once we got that, everything gets a bit easier. The game's pretty in-depth as far as I can see. Yeah, look, we got one stone. So we can make this stone pick now. And wait for that to craft. Okay. Still can't unlock anything else, so for now we want to start collecting some more resources, I think. If we chop another tree down, and we can use this pick to like destroy some rock. I don't really want to go out to that. Is there any rock up here? Oh, I'd rather not go into the water, but that's not far in. I don't even know if I'm going to be able to climb up onto it. No, that's not a good idea. Oh, there's some rock there. We'll run to that. Just slightly concerned about these dinosaurs here because they look like they might be an aggressive one. So we can get some flint from here. Hopefully some stone as well. A mixture of the two would be nice. Well, we got one stone. That's not too bad. We'll pick up some stones though, I think. If I put this away, I think I have to have an open hand to be able to pick up stones. Yeah, okay. There's loads lying around. I'll probably just grab a few of these. And when we level up, we can make a few more... A few more better tools, which will be good. Goals in the first episode. I think I'm going to try and get into a situation where we've got the tools we need to kind of make a good start. Oh yeah, as well, we're going to need food, and if we go to any of these kind of these wavy around plants, we can get different kinds of berries, which we can use and we can eat as our first kind of food source. I don't really want to be doing that. Oh, I leveled up and I missed it, but we'll go and do that now. And I can forage. Yeah, cause it might be a little while before we can like kill anything, and you know, when you get the meat you have to then cook it, so that involves making a fire and things. But in the meantime, we can keep our hunger, which is already down to 69. Hopefully we can keep it up by eating these berries. As far as I know, you can eat all of the berries. However, these ones stop you from getting knocked out, but they'll dehydrate you. And the black ones, the narco berries, will make you sleepy because they're mainly for use in taming dinosaurs later on. Okay, so we leveled up. I'm going to add this point onto health, and then it gives us engram points that we can use to unlock things here with. So I've got 8 points to spend. I'm going to learn how to make the hatchet, and I'm going to learn how to make the campfire. Because if it gets particularly cold, I can't make clothes yet, so I can get that campfire on, and I haven't actually crafted them. So what do I need to make? I can make the hatchet already. Okay, craft it. And I can make a campfire, so I'm actually going to get that made as well. Okay. I need to put those into my inventory, don't I? So I'll put the hatchet in there and I'll put the campfire in there so we can get that going if we need to. So now we've got a couple of different tools. If we use the hatchet on the tree, we're more likely to get wood. So see, we've got, already 26 wood there and we only picked up a couple of thatch. If we do it the other way around and use the pick on the tree, we should get loads more thatch and far less wood. So yeah, that's working out just fine. Now I believe that also works on... There's not many rocks around here that I can actually smash. I'm going to have to run over here. Just keeping an eye. I think that dinosaur there, that little one, is a spitting dinosaur, like the one from Jurassic Park. And if it... Yeah, it is. I'll be having a very bad day if I come face to face with that at the moment. So yeah, as it was with the on the tree, if we hit this with the pick, we're supposed to get predominantly flint, but there we got predominantly stone. And with the axe, we're supposed to get mainly stone. Okay, yes, that's kind of working out as expected. Okay, so what I need to do now is gather some stuff and that'll get me some XP to get up to the next level. Okay, so I haven't really gone anywhere and I've been just harvesting things in the local area. I've got a bunch of wood, stone, thatch, some flint. Probably could do with getting some more of that. Also collected quite a bit of fibre there and a bunch of berries that should keep me going hunger-wise for quite some time. Stock up on a few of those now to get my hunger level up. I'm not sure how much hunger a berry refills. It might actually be worth kind of doing a bit of a test on that, which I'm going to do in a minute, actually, as soon as that's levelled out. I'm not sure exactly how much hunger it refills. I know that meat does a lot more, but I'm not sure how much a berry does. Anyway, we can upgrade probably going to put another upgrade in health. And now we can buy a couple more things. So, we've got 10 Ingram points, so I'm definitely going to buy the spear. Yeah. I'm going to buy the clothes, I think. Or water skin. Clothes. I'm planning on staying by the water for a while. The water skin, it's like a water bottle. You can fill it up so you can go away from the water and you can still drink from that. So you don't get dehydrated. Yeah, well, I've spent it anyway. I've already done it. So we should actually be able to just craft the clothes straight away now anyway, because... Yeah. And we can craft a spear as well. We've got enough for that. I'm going to craft two spears. The reason I'm doing two is because they've got a chance of... They don't have a durability meter, but they have a chance of randomly breaking any time you use it. So if one breaks, I've got another one to take its place. If it breaks during a fight and you've only got one, bad news. In fact, I'm gonna make three of them because they do break, and weight isn't particularly an issue at the moment. I say that as she's getting pretty close, but that's upgradable later on, and it will break. So we've now got some clothes, we've got a weapon, we've got enough berries to keep us going for a little while. Oh yeah, we're gonna work out how much the brood is. So 68.8. It was about 1.5, was that? I think it was about 1.5. And we got some narco bearers as well. They're not going to last particularly long, so we might have to pick up some more of them. But those are what we can use to tame a first dinosaur with. So the next thing I think we'll do... It says I'm over-encumbered. I think. But I'm not. It won't let me run because I'm carrying too much. And split those. Split them again. Drop them. They're going to be the heavy thing. Alright, well, I'm not going to come in anymore, and I can pick up those later if I want them. So, we could do with finding some meat. And to do that, we'll see what kind of creatures we've got down here. Dodos would be good. We can go into the water and find the fish. They would be good as well. This thing's, as far as I'm aware, is peaceful. Ah, perfect. So we're going to need meat and hides. See, that broke already. That was quick. So now, I believe that the pick, if we hit it with the pick, yeah, it gives us a higher chance of getting meat. And if we hit it with the axe, it gives us a higher chance of hides, I think. Okay, let's try it out now. Let's see if we get hides. Yeah, okay. 7 hides just from that one. Okay, we'll go for the pick on this one, which has given us hides anyway, but it also gave us some meat. Okay, so we've got a bit of meat there for the first, our first meat. I think these guys are peaceful, they're herbivores. But there was definitely one of the more aggressive dinosaurs I saw down here before, which is why I'm keeping my eye out. I'm going to keep my spear loaded in case he pops out from somewhere. How's my food looking? 46. Well, use a few of those to get it up. At any point now, we can get the campfire and cook the meat that we found, so yeah, that's pretty cool. So far, so good. We've got our tools, we've got a couple of bits of clothes. Can't unlock anything else at the moment. The slingshot will be useful. And how far are we to leveling up? We're quite close to leveling up. It looks like night time's on the way, so I'll probably save the campfire for then. And probably do it down on the coast here. Something in the water there. So a quick check what that might... Okay, some fish. So these will be good because we can... We can kill these, really. Uh-oh. Oh, that wasn't good. Mega piranhas, level 1. Damn it. I wonder if I can find where I was. I mean, it looked pretty distinctive. Was it down there? I think it might have been down this way. I see if I can find where I was, because if I can find it, I can take all the stuff that I just lost. Because it would be a shame to have to start again now after that. The problem is... Yeah, this is the way. If I do find it, it's going to be in the water. With those freaking piranhas. Oh, my stamina's dropping. Okay. Found my body. Take all items. Excellent. Get out of the water. Okay, can I re-equip the clothing? I should be able to. Yeah. And shirt. And I've got all my stuff back in my inventory. Right, let's get a campfire going because it's getting dark. And I've got enough wood, I think. Yeah, stick it all in there and light it. Okay. There is an engram for a... Where is it? For a torch. Is it further on? Wooden club. Do I already have it? It's a standard one. Okay, so if I had more wood, I could actually craft one of those, which I can because... Oh, I'd put it all in the fire, didn't I? Take some of that back into my inventory. And... What am I doing? Pressing the wrong buttons. Craftables. Craft. From inventory, drop that into there. Okay, so now we can move around a bit more. We'll keep the campfire to keep coming back to. Oh, and we'll cook the meat that we got as well before it goes bad. Inventory for the fire. 5 raw meat. Okay, and I think during the night, because there's not much I can do, I don't really want to run around in the dark. I'll just gather some supplies from nearby, some more wood and things like that, just to keep stocked up on it, and come back when it's daylight again. Okay, so whilst gathering stuff, I managed to level up. So I think the next thing will increase is, and I'm probably doing this completely wrong, but I'm going to go for melee damage. Reason being, I think that'll be good. Potentially taming dinosaurs. So I've got 9 points to use, so I can potentially unlock 3 things. I mean, if I do a sleeping bag, can I sleep through the night? Is it even a good idea to do that? Will I get attacked? I do gloves and shoes, then I've got a full complement. Or I could do hat, gloves and shoes, then I've got all the clothing. Yeah. I'm going to do that. That's going to make it easier with the cold, I imagine. Can I craft these things? I can craft a hat. Oh, I need more fibre if I'm going to craft. Uncraft the gloves now, though. So let's put those things on because they're going to keep me warm. I think I can use this skin on that. Yep. Amazing. Gloves, why won't they go on? Hands, there we go. Also actually increases our armor level slightly. Each of these items has actually got an armor level 2, which I don't think is very high at all, but combined it's probably giving us a bit of extra protection in fights. Probably. Okay. Okay, collected some more stuff. Now we've got boots. Kind of got a full outfit going on, so yeah. We're looking good. Okay, so we're back to daytime after making it through the night. I'll put the fire out. And I think I've got a couple of spears. We'll go again. We could try and take out this guy. This gal even. But no, they seem peaceful and there's a few of them around. I don't want to get a pack on in. At least with the water we can kind of retreat back out of it. Okay, so that guy looks like bad news. It looks like this nest isn't necessarily the safest place to be. We killed it. Oh, yeah, we killed another one. Where did this body go? These coals. Those. Welcome. Okay, so we killed a decent amount of fish there. We've got 18 raw fish meats. So I'm going to just chuck those straight in the fire, I think, and cook them all up straight away, because they'll last a lot longer that way. Oh, I can't get rid of that. Chuck that in there. Lights. Okay, those are cooking. Okay, so we got some meat cooking on the campfire. We've gone up a few levels. We're almost at the next level. So I think we'll call it for episode one there. In episode two, come back, and what we're going to do is attempt to tame our first dinosaur. So in the meantime, I'm going to do a bit of research about what kind of dinosaur is the best. I don't know where to try and go for one of these big things. Whether that would be good, or whether to try and tame a small creature. But we'll look into that. So, thanks very much for watching. If you like the video, please subscribe to the channel. I'm going to keep putting a regular content, hopefully. Like I say, episode 2 should be up very shortly. Thanks very much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.